Snow White. Her vain and wicked stepmother, the queen, feared that someday Snow White's beauty would surpass her own. So she dressed the little princess in rags and forced her to be a scullery maid. One day, outside the castle, Snow White was busy cleaning and talking to some birds. And Snow White says, Snow White told the bird that if you make a wish into the bell and hear it echoing, your wish will soon come true. And bird one says, and so the hunter obeyed and took Snow White into the woods. But the hunter couldn't carry out the evil queen's plan. And the bird flies in and says,
Snow White, what are you doing to be so beautiful? Must be careful.
And the hunter says, and so Snow White ran deep into the woods until she stumbled upon a small cottage. She was exhausted from running and decided to take a nice long nap. But the bird flies away. In another part of the woods, the seven dwarfs were busy at work in the diamond mine. Thank you. youngest dwarf to see who it was. And she runs away. And Dunk says,
"Did you see it?"
And Bashful says,
"How big was it?"
And Sleepy says,
"Was it a dragon?"
And Grumpy says,
"Did it have fangs?"
And Sneezy says,
"Has it got horns?"
And Dunk says,
"Was it breathing fire?"
The dwarfs mustered up some courage and tiptoed back to the cottage. And when they got there, they discovered it wasn't a monster at all. They introduced themselves one by one.
The dog says,
"I'm
Dog."
And
Thank you.
With the dwarfs out of the way, the evil queen approached the cottage, disguised as an old hag. She presented Snow White with an apple. And told her that it was a magical wishing apple. The dwarfs heard the cackle and rushed back home. They chased the old hag up a hill. One day, the prince who had searched far and wide found Snow White and blew her kiss. He broke the magical